spiders.
I'm gonna need another shower.
Totally.
Good. And wait until he gets to the snowman, and then we can go. All right, go ahead.
Did I just let it?
And then when we get off, we're going to go to the right.
To the right.
And I'll meet you at the top.
Okay. Me too. Me too! I wasn't prepared for this.
How's it going?
Not good.
Lean forward.
Okay. Duck walk. Duck walk.
He's hacking up here.
I did this.
So, to start out, we're going to work on a gliding wedge. So to do that, we're going to start going, maybe shuffle a little bit, get a little bit of speed, and then we're going to get in a wedge like this. See, my toes are looking at each other, kind of what we did with those boot drills. So everybody see if you can make a wedge. So if we do a small wedge, we're going to go faster. If we do a big wedge, we're going to do the splits, exactly. We're going to do the splits or fall down, but we'll usually stop. So I'm going to do a little demo here. I'm not going to ski all the way down. Just maybe 10, 15 yards or so, okay? You're going to go one at a time and ski to me, maintain that wedge, and try to stop at me.
So how do we stop again?
What's that?
How do we stop again?
The wedge.
Just this?
Yeah. So look at, watch my skis. So I've got a little wedge, and if I want to make a big one, This is going to stop me. I'm on the inside edges of my ski. That's going to dig into the snow and grab the snow and make it stop. Okay? So kind of watch what I do. And then we'll go down one at a time after that. I'll call you individually.
Zachary said, oh no! I am looking at him. Dad,
oh, he called you, Jeremy.
I'm gonna have to like take something off. Danny's gonna break his ankle again.
He does it with a different ankle. That one has still played in.
Am I supposed to have them down?
Okay, my turn.
We're going fast!
Make it bigger.
I think I just like died. Oh no, my mom is. I'm gonna end up running Indy. Death walk.
Yeah.
that feel? What was difficult about that?
Stopping.
Okay. You finally started to get the stop, though.
Yeah.
How did you stop? Yeah. Good. So the key is, when we're stopping, we want to push our heels out. So keep pushing your heels out until you stop. Okay? Another thing, when we're skiing, we want to ski with an athletic stance. Okay, we don't want to be standing straight up or in some other weird position. Basically, what we kind of want is if you're like getting ready to jump or maybe shoot a jump shot in basketball. We want our knees bent a little bit, and we want our shins to be touching the tongue of the boot. That means we're flexing our ankles. When we're in a stance like that, we're very secure and we're very stable, and we're not gonna fall. Okay? So let's go back up and try it again.
Do we have the poles this time or no?
Do you want to use your poles?
It matters to me. I don't think it's gonna save me.
Yeah. Usually when you're just starting out, kind of poles are more of a hindrance.
So I used to teach roller skating, and to hold on to something made it worse.
Yeah. Focus on that rotation first. Once we start stopping well, we'll add another element into it. We'll add the poles, okay? We don't want to make it too complicated.
Yeah, I'm not gonna want to do this tomorrow.
The second day is probably better.
What?
The second day would be better if you were doing it tomorrow.
Yeah.
It would have been after the first thing.
Thank you.
I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere but backwards.
Push those heels out. The harder you do it, the more you're going to go slow, and you can stop. Additionally, if you want to stop, get up on our edges. Inside edge, okay? That's going to stop it. You want me to go first? I'll kind of just do the same thing.
Overheating.
Oh shoot, I'm so sorry. Zachary,
stop.
We're going very slow.
For when I stand still, the outside of my ankle hurts so bad I can barely stand it.
So I'm guessing it's probably a fitment issue. I mean, they're always pretty uncomfortable. I mean, they hurt my ankles as well. I think once you start moving, I just think your mind's kind of taken all that pain, and it's just not, you know, you're not receptive towards it. Ski boots are good. go ahead and go up.
Okay, toes together. Just kidding, no toes together.
No, I'm trying here.
Down somehow, so we have to go down this way, okay?
I'm done.
And then he said, I'm done right now.
Yeah.
What? Here,
you can sidestep or you duck walk?
Well, I'm not sure.
Dig your edges in. You're sliding back because you're on the flat part of the ski. Step reverse.
I'm digging him in and I'm still sliding. Okay, let's try this way.
Now side step.
Okay. Oh no, oh no, oh no.
Always be looking up. You know, kind of anticipate that stop coming. In your mind, you should be thinking, okay, I should probably slow down. I should make a bigger wedge. I should make a bigger wedge. And then finally, I should make the biggest wedge and get on my edge and stop. Okay?
hands up.
I don't know if I can do 3 hours of this.
So it's a lot of it's in this knee too. Alright? So take that knee. See that? That's gonna swing that. Alright,
standing still is awful.
Opening your chest up.
I have to take my gloves off. I can't have my hands sweating.
Are you facing back?
Yes.
2 seconds.
Okay. Start going. Start larger.
A little pass, but much better. Awesome. Keep going down.
Yes. I can't turn that fast anyways, Mama. Stop.
At least he's not stopping crying.
All right, go ahead. Let's shout where you go. Grab some water.
I'm good with this.
I'm guessing this is the next one. This is the next level right here.
I'm guessing
but you
not.
You just swallow them here first.
What's that? It's hard to do with gloves.
So where should our hands be when we sleep?
I'm guessing right here because that's what you told me.
The guy downstairs said like you're holding a pizza.
Holding a pizza.
Oh, tray.
Exactly. With poles, I like to think of these as flashlights, okay? They're illuminating your way down the hill. So we always want to hold them out here. We always want our hands out here. Having our hands out there forces our upper body to be a little bit forward, which is going to be the most stable position. Okay, we get in trouble when we start leaning back or we start flailing arms like this. That throws all the, it throws a huge imbalance in there and then we fall. When we ski, what part of our body is doing the most work? Is it the upper body or the lower body? Always. So we're going to try turning next. When we turn, it's just the lower body. We want to keep our upper body super still. So, if I'm going to turn that way, okay, towards the lift line, what does my body do? Anybody have any idea? What?
Shift left.
No, no shifting. No shifting. Basically, if I want to go that way, if I've got my skis on, I'm still going to be in the wedge. I'm just going to apply more pressure to this outside ski. Okay? A lot of people do. A lot of people think it's the inside. Nearly all that pressure should be on the outside ski. This one.
Actually, that makes sense.
This one, this inside, should be light as a feather. So light, in fact, you should be able to kind of just pick it up. Okay? Conversely, if I'm going towards the club over here, I'm going to put all the pressure on my left ski. Okay? Again, hanging in the wedge, which is more pressure on this ski. And then if I
more
turn,
pressure on the inside or the outside?
Outside. Always outside ski. So cool. We're going to try some turns next. And then kind of see how that goes. And honestly, you guys are doing really well. We probably have a chance of getting on the lift before it closes. Yeah, as long as you're up for it.
If I fall, nobody will laugh at me, right?
Everybody's gonna fall.
Okay.
That's hopefully not the goal.
He'll laugh at me.
But
yeah, he'll laugh. Don't worry about him.
As long as we can, we got to get a little bit better at our stops as well.
Right.
Stop consistently. Stop on point, and then. We'll incorporate some turns. Turning comes so much more naturally when you learn how to stop. Okay, you'll be surprised at how easy it is. Jeremy's already doing some turns. A lot of people do them and they don't even know how to do it. Let's go ahead and go back up. Yeah, do that duck walk. Kind of uncomfortable.
Inside, inside, inside. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. A little better.
A little better.
We'll get
better
there.
Than school, though.
That's true. That's true. Okay. Turn. Turn. Nope. 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 Okay. Okay.
Turn your feet.
Okay.
You lean back. You lean back, you're gonna fall.
So this time we're gonna turn around my feet. We're gonna go towards the fence. Which ski is gonna have the most pressure on it?
Turn towards the fence, so I'm gonna lean on this one.
Not really lean, you don't wanna throw your center of mass off, okay? That's when you fall. You just wanna put more pressure on this.
Like your big toe.
Yeah, like you're squishing a bug or stepping on a can, something like that.
Okay.
Put more pressure there.
And then that'll turn you that way. And then, I haven't set the other pole out, but once you make that turn, then do another turn, and then stop at the end. So why don't you go ahead.
Turning.
We're going around the pole that little kid just knocked down. And go back the other way, like slalom, basically.
He can't hear you.
I was talking to Daddy.
Oh.
Not Zachary. I know Zachary can't hear me.
Huh? Okay. I'm probably going to do the same thing, but take a picture of me.
Yeah. And really, when you do this, look how much more. So here's that neutral zone you were talking about. If this is your turn, there's that neutral zone where your skis are parallel, just like that, or a little bit of a light wedge. Then you go into some of that right arm down, the right arm up.
Oh, you're killing me.
My feet are killing me.
Feet are okay, my legs are killing me.
You know that painting that's like, paint me one?
That's what?
Paint me like one of your French girls or something like that. I don't know how much longer I can stand. Okay.
I was trying to make my skis parallel. I didn't know I was supposed to keep them the whole time.
Okay. Yeah.
Every single time I try, I get a cramp.
You need to get over your cramp and you need to eat more balanced food if your muscles are cramping that bad. So they shouldn't cramp like that. Every once in a while, sure, but not every time.
So you're still getting these positions when you're like this. You need to have on your wedge just a few inches of space between. Okay?
I'd go step on it for you, but I don't think I can do that.
The turns look pretty good. Melinda, you really kind of learned and stopped kind of shifting your weight on those last turns, and everything was really square.
I was trying to get my feet parallel before, and that's what wasn't working.
Oh, you're trying to get them parallel.
Yeah. Apparently that's not what I was supposed to do. Right?
Not yet. Once we master those wedge turns, yeah. And once we get in ski on the mountain a little bit, the next step is going to be to parallel. Okay. Let's go back up, and I want you to continue working on turning.
Stopping.
And both of you stopping. Okay.
Where are we supposed to be stopping?
About.
So, last time I put my pole in the ground.
Right
there.
I want you stopping right where the pole is.
Right there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right in front of it. Try to get as close as you can without running it over or touching it.
Okay.
You need water?
Is there any?
There's some down here for your services.
Better and better each time.
Kind of.
Sometimes it seems like you're running on time, but I think that what you could do is
Okay. Simple, simple.
Alright. You guys are gonna stop before you hit the pole. Okay? Gauge your speed. Start to get in that wedge. Be sure when you stop, you're getting on those inside edges. Okay? The weight and pressure is on the inside of the foot in order to accomplish that. Alright? And Melinda, I'll have you turn again. Okay? I'm gonna go down.
Do you wanna go first or do you want me to go first?
I'll go first. I haven't been doing this. I've just been like. Just kidding, that's not what I'm
doing. Always remember to go back to the neutral zone before you go into the next one.
You're turning.
So. Let me just do what a woman
No, he told you just to do exactly what you did last time.
Bigger. Perfect. That's good. That was good.
Okay.
Try not to cross the tips though.
I got a cramp.
What?
I got a cramp right here.
Yeah, my cramp's like right here. On the horse is right here.
I feel bad.
Yeah.
I feel.
Much better at stopping. What clicked? What clicked?
Just pushing it in more.
Yeah, pushing it out farther. Alright, we're still going to do some more practice. I want to give you guys your poles now.
Okay.
We're going to do poles here.
Thank you.
All right, let's go back up. You guys hot or anything?
Yes.
Burning up.
You want to take a break? Get some water?
Yes.
Okay.
Because I'm starting to get a headache.
Yeah, let's do that. Just come over here to the fence. Take everything out.
Okay. toe. Almost.
Okay. All right, let's go back up the carpet and we'll meet up top. When you're on the magic carpet, hold your poles in one hand until you hit the snow. Once you hit the snow, then you can use it.
Now we're going to go a little bit faster. The stopping point is going to be on the bottom. So I want you to get speed, and I want you to get control of your speed. Cone in on this as a stop sign. Figure out what you need to do in order to stop right in front of it. Just like both of you did last time. Okay? We're going to have a little demonstration. Except I'm going to be the stick this time. So please don't hit me. Okay.
That last one, huh?
Okay, glider, don't cross them.
Yeah, good. I like what you're doing with your hands too. You're holding your pulse correctly. I think we're ready for the lift.
Oh no.
Yeah, I'll be fine. You'll be fine, trust me. I would take more
Mom, I'm not turned yet.
If you can get her, that way we can go. Practice a couple more times again with that speed and stopping. We're not taking this lift over here,
okay?
Either of these. It's the one way down there. It's the bunny hill.
Okay.
So let's do a couple more practice. This is kind of a guided practice right now. Either work on your stops, speed, turns,
wait,
or some combination of all
three. Can you put two things so we can practice turning and stopping?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. With your poles. If you're having trouble, hold them like this. I want you to hold them out in front of you like it's a tray. Okay? Not like that. That's speed racing position. Okay? We just want to be like this. And that's going to help keep our upper body stable on our turns. Okay? So go ahead and go up. And then I will plant my poles.
Jump in front of your second. Thank you.
I tried to catch up with my suit.
That's okay. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
If that ain't me. You can if you want.
Right? You're on the first one, the left, the second one, and vice versa.
You push down. See how it grips?
on the snow, but you have to pressure it. Otherwise, if you don't, here's what happens. You don't.
Slide in like that.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
So, the goal is to brush it from.
Same thing, either way. You go right around the first one, but if you go right around the first one, go left around the second.
Okay, I'll try my best.
Do you got it?
I think we're going to go up and do
it. Hold on, let's wait for him.
Same thing, except
like opposite.
What?
The opposite.
You can do opposite if you want, but I'm going to be down here and you have to stop right in front of me.
Alright.
Okay. What, have you guys noticed, if you change the amplitude of that pressure, so if you put a lot of pressure on your outside
you screen, go faster?
You're going to get you a sharper turn.
Yeah.
So kind of keep that in mind. If you put a lot of pressure on there, the turn's going to be a lot sharper, rather than if you just put some gradual pressure on there. Let's go ahead and get back up.
This is almost dead. Turn it off.
Battery for the bigger one.